Hello dear friends, welcome to Shiksha Mantra, and here we are going to learn something very much critical in English grammar. And rather, I won't call it critical, but something which you must learn to know how to construct an English sentence properly. These are really very much important because sometimes we do need a lot to invert a sentence, and that is done in terms of verbs, and this is called the inversion. And this is our topic today. We'd learn how to use inversion in English grammar so that we can form the sentences properly. And here we are going to learn the details about them. So let's start. What is inversion? In several different structures, the auxiliary verb comes before the subject. This is usually referred to as inversion. So here we begin with the inversion of subject and auxiliary verb. So let's learn how to do this, how to do this inversion, that is the change of position regarding the subject and auxiliary verb, here in our next slide. So it would be about questions. So what happens? Written questions have the following word order: auxiliary verb plus subject plus main verb. So I'm repeating it. When it's a written question, we have the following word order, that is auxiliary verb plus subject plus main verb. So how it is, note that only the auxiliary verb goes before the subject. The main verb goes after the subject. So how is it? Let's check an example. Has John arrived? So if you check this, has, this is the auxiliary verb, then comes John, the subject, and then the main verb, arrived. So we can't write it down as has arrived John. And if we check another example, they, have they agreed to come, not have agreed they to come. So the verb gets bifurcated and the subject takes the place in the middle of auxiliary verb and the main verb. So this is the most important inversion that happens with questions. So let's check what's next. In questions, beginning with a question word, that is where, when, why, how, the auxiliary goes after the question word and before the subject. So with these question words, where, when, why, how, etc., the auxiliary goes after the question word and before the subject. So how is it? Let's check an example. What are you doing here? So if you check it, what, that's the WH word or the question word. So here we are using are, then the subject you, and then the main verb doing. So we can't write it down as what you are doing there or what you doing there. So our production of sentences, be it written form or spoken form, whatever it may be, it would be what are you doing there, and that's quite common. Almost every one of us know this, but we must remember them when we are going to use them in practical field, whether in spoken or in written. So let's check what comes next. Note that the inversion of subject and auxiliary verb does not always happen in spoken questions. In spoken questions, the meaning is usually conveyed through intonation. How? If I take this sentence, you are coming with me. So here I am asking a question with a normal assertive construction, and it's not interrogative construction. So it's spoken, and the question's actual meaning is, are you coming with me? But when I am in spoken language, I can manage this with intonation. So I may use this sentence here as, you're coming with me? But it can't happen when we are in written English. So indirect questions also don't have the inverted word order. Put your ultimate focus here, because most of the time, the students are found make mistakes for these sentences. When it's indirect question, like this, I wondered what he was going to do. So this is an indirect question. It's not a direct. Here we are not using any quote, or this is, you can find that it's an indirect narration. So here you would have to write it down as what he was going in normal structure of assertive sentence, that is in SVO format. And you can't say, I wondered what was he going to do. It's not the proper fact. And then comes another example. After this, we'll discuss it a little bit. She asked where I was going, not where was I going. So if you have learned narration changes, there one particular rules is followed, that whatever sentence it is in direct speech, when it's converted into indirect, you'd have to use the assertive form. You can't use interrogative form or exclamatory form or optative form. You have to use the assertive form. So here no question of what was he going to do appears. So here verb cannot lead. That's a simple thumb rule to follow, and you won't get mixed things up, because most of the time you are fine making mistakes with them. So students, remember it properly, and it's going to help you a lot in future. So let's check what's waiting for us with may. So what happens when we use may? The auxiliary may comes before the subject in wishes. So if it's wishes, may would come before the subject, like this: may God bless you. So God, this is the subject, and may comes before this, not God may bless you. Remember it, remember it properly. It's going to help you a lot. So then comes after so, neither, and nor. What happens for them? The auxiliary goes before the subject in short answers after words like so, neither, and nor. What short answer? I don't like cricket. Neither do I. So this is the short answer. Neither do I. You can't say neither I do. I'm hungry. So am I. You can't say so I am. So this is very much important, and you'd have to remember them well. Otherwise, there might be some mistake, and these mistakes are unwanted as well. So let's check what we are going to learn. We are going to learn inversion after negative expressions. This is also very much important, dear students. Remember it quite well. So what happens with negative expressions? The first is, when a negative adverb or expression is put at the beginning of a sentence, it is usually followed by auxiliary verb plus subject. So here are some structures to follow. These structures are mostly formal. This is what we must put focus on. These structures are mostly formal structures, like this: under no circumstances can we appoint him as director. Not under no circumstances we can appoint him as a director. So here it begins with a negative adverb, and so we have to put the auxiliary verb first, then the subject. There's another: not until much later did she realize that she had made a huge mistake. Not until much later she realized that she had made a huge mistake. No, we must do this as did she realize, and not she realized. And there comes another. Inversion is also used after negative words like hardly, seldom, rarely, little, never, and after expression containing only. So remember these words. You may pause the video, write them down, and also I'm going to show you one after another their uses. You can write them down, and it is very vital for many parts of your English grammar knowledge, like this: hardly. Hardly had I reached the station when the train arrived. Not hardly I had reached the station. So here you'd have to use it as hardly had I. Then comes seldom. Seldom have I seen such a mess. Not seldom I have seen such a mess. Then comes little. Little did he realize the danger he faced. Only then did I understand what was happening. So little did he realize, and only then did I understand what was happening. So this must be remembered well, or you are going to make mistakes. No sooner had she read the letter Then she started crying. So no sooner had she, you can't say no sooner she had read the letter. And the last one, scarcely had I solved one problem when another cropped up. Scarcely had I, not scarcely, I had. So you may pause the video here and write down all the examples with the rules, and it's going to help you a lot. Then comes another very important part. So note that these structures are rather formal or literary, the structures we have discussed so far in our previous slide. In less formal style, we begin these sentences with their proper subjects. How? I had hardly reached the station when the train arrived. There we were saying hardly had I, and here I had hardly reached the station. I have seldom seen such a mess. So these are not formal. These are rather informal, less formal style. We mustn't say informal, but less formal. So that's all here. You have the comment box for all your suggestions and questions. And if you like this, obviously, we demand a like from your part. And if you have faith on my channel, you may subscribe to this channel also with the notifications so that you get all the notifications regarding all our videos at an early time. So that's all. Thank you for watching.